Hey guys, it's Caitlin.
Because I'm 18 and I still live with my parents. Yeah, they're not like yours. Well, yours are more understanding. I've never fell in love. I save those feelings for you. So let's do all this.
And today I'm going to be doing a glowy Valentine's Day makeup look. A lot of people wanted me to do a makeup look for Christmas and I didn't do one, but I think that Valentine's Day is like a cute little flirty holiday, and if you want to go out with your special someone or just chill at home and watch Netflix and eat chocolates but look glam and glowy and natural and cute at the same time, then this look is gonna be perfect for you. So we're gonna get started. My Clinique Moisture Surge face spray for thirsty skin. This is what it looks like. It's just a small little travel size, but I love this. I think it is so good. I've used a lot of this since I got it, and since we're going for like that healthy glowy look, I think this is awesome. So I just spray it into my face and I just massage it in with my fingers, and then I spray it on my face after I'm done with my makeup, and I just think it feels so good. It's a setting spray, it's a primer, it's a rejuvenating spray. Like if you're dry during the day, spritz some of this on your face and you will love it. I get this at Sephora with my points. I used 100 points and bought this, and I think it's so good. Oh, next thing is your base. I'm not gonna be using a primer, that's my primer. But if you want to even out your entire skin tone, then you can use a foundation. If you wanna just hide the bags, then you could use concealer. But today I'm going to be using a foundation. This is a very light to medium coverage foundation, and I think it's really, really good for just evening out the skin tone and making your skin look natural. So if you want just pure natural makeup, then I would definitely just use a concealer. I could definitely use a concealer right now, but I think I'm just gonna even out my entire skin tone because I think like a glowy skin tone and natural makeup would be like a nice even skin. So do what you're comfortable with, but I'm gonna be taking my Estee Lauder Double Wear Nude Cushion Stick Foundation. That's what it looks like. It was in the shade 1N2, and this just comes with a little sponge applicator right here. Oh, that might be a bit dark, but I like this foundation. It evens out your skin tone. It's light to medium coverage, it's buildable, and it has a built-in sponge to spread the product. But obviously you could use a beauty blender or oval brush or whatever. So I like to just spread it out on my face and then go in with my oval brush and do the rest. But you can see how glowy our skin looks, and that's not sweat. That is actually the Clinique spray and this foundation. It's dewy, it's gorgeous, and I really like it. So definitely recommend this foundation. It's so good. But we're going for a natural dewy face look. So I'm gonna go in with this. This is my CoverGirl Clean Pressed Powder. It's a normal skin pressed powder. Mine's in the shade 130 Classic Beige. I hit pan on this. I haven't used this in a very, very, very long time. But if I remember correctly, it mattifies your face, but leaving some dew, which is what we want. Like right now, we look oily. So we're just gonna put a little bit of powder to mattify, but still look dewy. And I'm gonna take my Clinique spray and I'm gonna spritz that on my face. Next time that I go to Sephora, I'm definitely getting another one of these samples. They're so good, I really like this. Taking my Wet n Wild bronzer, I don't use anything else besides this. So if you ever see me using anything besides this, you know it's good. It's so pigmented, it blends out so well, and it's from the drugstore. So I definitely recommend this. I think just a nice bronzy touch to your face makes your face look healthy and glowy. I also think that a healthy looking face has a blush to the skin. I just think that that makes your skin look super nice. So we're gonna go with this. This is the e.l.f. Cream Blush Palette in the shade Soft. I did a first impressions, and this was one of the products that I tried out, and I really, really, really like it. So I'm just taking this angled brush, and it's a, kind of like a stippling brush, but there's no product on it right now. But I'm trying not to blind you with this big old mirror. But I'm gonna take a combination of these two shades. They're like peachy shades, and I think that just adding a little bit to the apples of your cheeks makes them look so pretty, and then bringing it back right here. So now we're gonna go into my favorite part, which is definitely the glow. This is my Anastasia Glow Kit in the Style Sugar, or Shade Sugar, whatever you wanna call it. That's what it looks like. The shades are so gorgeous. I love it. There's also a video coming up where I did a first impressions using this, so go watch it. It'll probably be up before this video. And all I do is I spritz my brush with water. You could definitely use that Clinique spray if you wanted to, or a setting spray, or literally just water. I like to save my Clinique spray for my face, so I just use water. But I'm taking my glow kit, and I think a glow should be very blinding, but if you want a natural glow, then do that. I'm gonna take the shade Marshmallow, which is right here. It's my favorite shade in the whole palette, because look how blinding. You can't tell me that you're not blinded by this. If you were driving past me in a car and you saw this, you would get into a car accident because it's so blinding. I'm gonna go into the brows. A lot of people like natural brows, but I am a full glam type of girl when it comes to the brows. That's what I did. We have our base complete. We have the blinding glow, the wispy brow, the natural face looking like you're wearing no makeup. So now we are gonna go onto the eyes. This makes the look the look. So I'm gonna start with my Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. I think this is the perfect palette for this look. It's literally called Peach, and it has a lot of peach shades that are super good for Valentine's Day glam. I'm gonna take White Peach, which is literally just a white shade on a fluffy brush. And I always use this shade to set my lid. So now we're gonna go in with a peachy shade. Remember, if peach isn't your type of thing, you can go in with a brown, anything. If you wanna glam, glam it up. But this is the natural look. So I'm gonna take the shade Georgia, which is right here. It's this very, very light peachy pink shade. And I'm gonna build it up on my brush quite a bit. And I'm gonna plop this in the crease. Okay, so Georgia is in my crease. It's a nice neutral pink. Our highlight is still blinding everybody. So now I'm gonna go in with this shade, and this is the shade Just Peachy. It is a shimmery pink peach. And I'm gonna take it on the same fluffy brush. I'm grabbing a tiny bit, not too much. And I'm gonna put this right under the crease shade. I'm gonna take my Estee Lauder brush. It's just a small tapered brush, and I'm gonna go into this shade. This is called Candied Peach, and it's right there. Okay, so I have to do this. This wouldn't be a pinky Valentine's Day look if I didn't use my Modern Renaissance palette. This palette is the queen of pinky shades. As you can tell, you know which one I'm gonna use. So I'm gonna use the shade Love Letter right here. These shades are so much more pigmented than the Sweet Peach palette, so you have to be careful that you don't grab too much. I always just dip it in and wipe it on my hand and then go. And I'm taking the Love Letter in my outer V with the small fluffy tapered brush, if that makes any sense. It's like fluffy and tapered, so you can't go too crazy with it. And I'm just bringing that out on my outer portion of my lid. Oh, we are done with the pinky shade there, so I'm gonna add a couple more finishing touches. I think a thing that would set this off really pretty but still keep it natural is taking a tapered pencil brush, going in with Love Letter, and popping this on the bottom lash line. If you think this is too much, then please don't do it. I think it's really gonna set off the look and make it look very pretty. So this is what the eye look looks like. I think it is gorgeous, like stunning, and I think it looks very, very pretty on blue green eyes. It makes them pop like my eyes. You could see them from a mile away, and I think that's really gorgeous. So now we're gonna go in with, I'm gonna go back in with my glow kit, and I'm gonna take the pinky peachy shade, and I'm gonna just take it on my finger and pop that in the inner corner. Uranus could spot me from Georgia. Just saying, you could see me from the moon. I would look like a star on Earth because I am so glowy. Now we're gonna finish up this glowy Valentine's Day glam. Okay, so now I look alive. I finally have my mascara on. I honestly think that this look pops your eyes so much. I think if you have brown eyes, it would be super pretty along with green or blue or yellow or purple or hazel or any color eyes that you have. We don't discriminate. Eyes are beautiful the way they are. So obviously you could go in with a gloss. You could do whatever you want. This look is gorgeous. I think a gloss would be gorgeous, but I'm going to use a lip liner first. I'm gonna be using my Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place Lip Pencil. This is what it looks like. But this is a really, really pretty color. I think it would be great for Valentine's Day. I'm just gonna take the little brush on the end and kind of sweep it. Ugh, got it on my lip. I feel like that just elevated it. That made it super, super, super shiny. And my lips are blinding. So that is the look. I think it's gorgeous. This is a great, great look. I would rock this on an everyday basis, and I think it is so pretty. So definitely give this video a big old thumbs up. Subscribe down below to join the Katesters. And I love you guys so much. Please tell me your opinions down below on the look. I think it is so pretty. And I'll see you guys next time I post. Have a wonderful Valentine's Day. Mwah. Bye, guys.